Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Rousseau, the visionary thinker, once said, "Man is born free, yet everywhere he's in chains." Rousseau had written this famous book called The Social Contract, which became the bulwark of social democracy, freedom, liberty, and secularism throughout the world. Today, people like me, the liberals, are a bane to society. That's what people with rigid ideas who like dwelling into the past like to think so. Now, I'll tell you why they think that we are exactly a bane to people's existence. It's because we don't look backwards, nor do our thoughts tarry with yesterday. We like looking forward. Now, today, you must have noticed a trend on social media that the word liberal has almost become like a cuss word. And there's so much of vitriol that is being spewed upon all over social media that people like me, who actually advocate free thought, liberty, secularism, inclusivity, are termed as traitors. So tell me, how did this come about? And how did we exactly reach here, where people who actually talk about sharing the pie with everyone else, their neighbors think that they would be excluded from that specific pie that they hold so greatly? My belief is that in being inclusive, I share all the privileges that has been accorded to me. However, my detractors feel that I become a traitor because I'm taking something away from them, something that they hold so dearly. That is their special status and privilege. Now, the danger is that when you iterate, discuss, collaborate ideas, it becomes an exchange of ideas, and ideas by itself are great. However, the challenge is that when ideas become solidified and become ideologies, the stakeholders of these ideologies become authoritarians by itself. They feel protectors of that ideology. So, my friends, what happens is the whole expression, freedom of thought, freedom of speech, that gets jeopardized because the stakeholders of liberty, freedom, free speech feel that they are the owners of a specific ideology. So like I said, this whole thing, the vitriol that is floating day by day on social media, person to person, it definitely stems from there. And it stems from rigidity of ideas. By looking into the past and finding out a new narrative, by not flowing with the water, by not going forward. So ladies and gentlemen, this is how I see it is. Now, when you look at the term liberalism, what does it mean? Do any of you recall a very phenomenal photograph of the Statue of Liberty? Yeah, everyone has seen it? Now, what does that emote? What does that signify? Well, the Statue of Liberty was gifted by the French people to the Americans when Americans declared their independence. And that whole statue is so symbolic because here is this Roman goddess, Libertas. She's walking forward. There's a crown over her head, which she's holding. And there is a torch that she holds with her right hand. Left hand is a tabula and sata. On the right side, on her feet, she's actually leaving chains, fetters, and walking in front. That also connotes something really pertinent. That is when slavery got abolished. This Statue of Liberty was symbolic because abolition of slavery was such a big thing. You are actually doing away with a specific retrograde, regressive tradition, and you're just walking ahead into the future. whose dimension you cannot even imagine, not even in your wildest dream. So one cannot ever fathom the empowerment, the freedom gives to you. Now, Rousseau, in his book, The Social Contract, also said that the man's greatest boon is the gift of free will. Now, what happens is that when man comes in contact with people, with society, with intrusive laws and regulation, when they start policing other people's behavior, that free will gets jeopardized. So Rousseau's work in The Social Contract is actually a bulwark of democracy, of freedom, because he devised a way in which man can retain their individuality and at the same time they get to engage with ideas. So there is an accusation that liberals lack clarity. Ladies and gentlemen, friends, we couldn't be further from the truth, because each of us bring to the table clarity of thoughts, clarity of ideas, and that comes only with iteration, debate, engagement, arguments, without which, like I said, we all in our own ways become authoritarians. And that is not the good way in how we should progress in the 21st century, in the new millennium. When we feel that our idea is the only idea, his idea does not count, and we are just 1,000 miles when we disengage and become custodians of what we think is good for society, good for progress. Now, when we talk about engagement, calibration is also equally important. You talk about any contentious issues, bring in 370, bring in Article 377. My contention is that be willing to engage with people who have a different point of view, because your thought is not the gospel truth. There are other people who have ideas, and as long as they are not deterrent to society, as long as the ideas are not radical, moment people's ideas become radical, that is when your free thought, your spirit is in jeopardy. So the interesting thing is, every day I open my social media handles, and whenever I talk about inclusivity, being a free spirit, advocating liberty, advocating human rights, I hear cuss words every day. And you know, it can become a bane. You should help others get a share of their pie. So people feel that they're going about their business, and what they do is they put up the pictures of the pizzas and the parties they attended. All very well, put up your pictures of your pizzas, put up your pictures of your parties, your dinners, your lunches. However, what happens is, when you're not part of the dialogue, when you're not part of the narrative, when you don't speak up, you are actually a part of the problem. You're not part of the solution. At worst, we become fence sitters or comfortably numb. And being comfortably numb means you're giving momentum to an advocacy, to an idea that is not 1,000 miles away from authoritarianism. So ladies and gentlemen, the fact that we are here in this room and we're talking about ideals that is close to our heart shows that liberalism is not obsolete and democracy is alive, thriving. However, what we need to do is we need to engage, calibrate, respect others' point of view rather than name-calling them, shaming them, and calling them traitors, calling them horrible names. Because here, end of the day, collectively, what do we want? Close. We need to introspect into our hearts and say that we want an inclusive, broad-minded society that is not based on superstitions, on regressive traditions. But let me tell you, let me iterate once again. When I talk about tradition, I'm not telling you not to celebrate festivals, not to celebrate things that have been bequeathed to us from generation to generation. What I'm saying is respect other people's traditions as well, along with respecting yours. That doesn't make me a traitor if I'm celebrating my traditions as well as celebrating yours. That doesn't mean that I'm an enemy of religion and tradition, definitely not. What I'm actually striving for is a freer society, a freer sharing of thoughts, ideologies, and yes, I iterate. I also mean free press. When press is throttled and they become the spokespersons of the powers to be, democracy, ladies and gentlemen, is in danger. End of the day, a journalist's job is to report. A journalist's job is not to be a stooge and become a yes man. A journalist's job is to be neutral and to report any chain of events as it comes by, and not with a single prism of thought just to please his or her political masters. So ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to iterate once again that today we are moving into a world where the entire continents are becoming one. Globalization has changed the world, the way we look at things. Now you look at the mobile phone, see the way it has revolutionized the world. We couldn't ever envisage that you could be tapping away with your mouse and send across an email that would reach the other end of the globe. Today it is happening. It is happening because of ideas. It is happening because of inventions. Let's not forget today that rubbing together of Flintstones actually invented fire. Calibrating, discussing, ideating led to the invention of the wheel, led to the invention of the airplane, led to the invention of the smartphone that we happily carry in our pockets. So let us look into the future, a future which you and I cannot even envisage, not even in our dreams. The infinite is future, ladies and gentlemen, and infinity does not come by looking over our shoulders, by dwelling into our past and deriving our convictions. Our convictions come from the future, by taking a step into the right direction, by looking forward, and then I would say liberalism would become your home today and tomorrow. And with that, I throw open the doors and liberalism remains my home. Thank you so much for having me here.